Good afternoon. Live now to Canberra, where Prime Minister Scott Morrison is speaking.
Minister for Foreign Affairs and the Minister for Finance to release the Jenkins Review. A little while ago, I had the opportunity to speak to Kate Jenkins and thank her for the tremendous work that she has done at our request in establishing the independent review into Commonwealth parliamentary workplaces. I want to thank Kate and Jenkins and all of her team, not just for undertaking this review, but the incredibly professional and sensitive manner in which they undertook this review. This is a difficult issue. It's a sensitive issue. It's a very vulnerable issue for people, understandably. I also want to thank all of those who have participated so well with the conduct of this review, and sharing their experiences, telling their stories, and importantly, making their suggestions about how we can make this place a safer workplace for everyone who works here, not just the members of Parliament and senators, and indeed our staff, but indeed everyone who works here, including those who are assembled here today. I also want to thank Brittany Higgins for her courage in speaking up about these issues in relation to the terrible events that led her to make those statements. And obviously, I have to be careful about what I say about these matters, and you'll understand given where those matters are currently. So please don't take that as anything other than me seeking to support that proper process. But more generally, I do thank her for standing up and speaking up. And her voice has been listened to, not just in the actions that we have already taken, but in the report that is being prepared now by Kate Jenkins. And her voice has spoken for many, as this report shows, and the concerns and experiences that they have had in so many occupations working here in this building. So I thank her for that. I thank her for the fact that by speaking up, the actions already undertaken to establish the Parliamentary Workplace Support Service, which provides that 24/7 support that was not here when Brittany was dealing with the terrible events that occurred. The independent complaints mechanism that has been established, both of these following on for the Foster report, and I thank Stephanie Foster, who has also worked very closely with Kate Jenkins to ensure the work that she has done is dovetailing well into the work that Kate Jenkins is doing. And of course, the rollout of workplace training that has occurred. All of these things already, even before we get to working on the recommendations of this report on a multi-party process, have already made this workplace safer than indeed when Brittany was working here. But not safe enough. Not safe to the standard that all of us who work in this place would expect. As this Parliament and everybody who works here, in whatever capacity, this place should be the centre of standards. And that is what I believe this report seeks to achieve. And I thank everybody who has played a role in doing this. These events have drawn attention to this workplace. And these are not new issues. This report, while dealing specifically in talking to people who work here now, those who have been working in this place for a long time, whether it is you, some of you who have joined us here today, indeed, Senator Payne, who's been longer here than either Senator Birmingham or myself, know that these challenges in this work, these deficiencies and appalling behaviour that has taken place here, this is not new to this place, and it is applied to governments, workplaces, past, present, going back over a long period of time. And it's important we understand that, because these sort of cultures don't appear in a short period of time. They've been around a long time. And I'm pleased that our government, working together with the opposition and the other parties represented in this parliament, did come together and respond so quickly to these events and have taken action together, and to do so on a multi-partisan basis, because that's the only way we are going to be able to properly address these issues. We all share in the ownership of the problems that are set out in this report, but we all share in implementing the solutions as well, and we each have a role to play. regardless of what role you have, whether you're a Prime Minister, a Minister, leaders of parties in this place, which recommendations specifically address, whether you're senior members of staff, whether in parliamentary offices or other offices in this building, or indeed you're a member of staff here and working in the many roles that are in this building. We all share in these problems and we all share in their solutions. This was initiated by the government as a multi-party process to fix and address a very, very serious problem, one that we must continue to address in this workplace, as indeed workplaces all over the country must also address. I also want to thank Kate Jenkins especially for her insights into the drivers of this appalling behaviour that people have suffered in this place, and the impacts of that behaviour on people. The power imbalance, the gender imbalance, the lack of accountability for behaviour, as well as understanding the challenging and demanding work environment that is in this building. But I want to stress, just as I think Kate Jenkins does, and I'm sure my colleagues support and people across this building, just because this is a challenging and demanding environment, just because we work under great stress and strain and long hours and deal with issues that are of great import for the future of our nation, that is all true. Similarly, as you deal with deadlines and various pressures in your workplace, stresses in workplaces such as this are real. But this is no excuse whatsoever to normalise inappropriate, unhealthy and unprofessional behaviour. Just because what you do is important and stressful and demanding can never normalise that behaviour as being somehow okay. It's not okay. And we all need to understand the drivers here. Of course we do important things in this place. It's a great privilege to be here and do those things. That should only stress upon us the need for those higher standards, not for lesser. We have been confronting these impacts. People are living with them. The physical and mental health impacts, the impacts on their careers more broadly, and their wellbeing. And I thank again Kate Jenkins for highlighting those in these report. The recommendations cover, I think, all the important territory that we must address together. As employees, and I speak now as the member for Cook, not just as the Prime Minister, but as the member for Cook, I'm an employer. The people in this building who are members and senators are employers. And this report reinforces that they are employers. And we all must understand how we can be the best employers we possibly can be, how we hire people, how we support people, how we ensure that they are developed and nurtured in the course of the career and find the reward work they do here rewarding and positive. And it is a very positive experience for them. That's our responsibilities as employers. And we have a great privilege to hold that position. So I'm looking forward to continuing the multi-party process that we have begun and continuing to work together to address all of these issues in good faith. I want to keep people around the table on this. I want to ensure that we engage with each other in good faith. Expect, of course, that we all perform to high standards. That's what we expect from all of our staff and everybody who works here, but respect them as individuals and their aspirations and what their expectations are of a safe workplace. So the actions. As a first step, I've asked the Minister for Finance and the Special Minister of State to consult with the opposition, minor parties and the independents on a way forward to respond to Commissioner Jenkins' review. Secondly, I've instructed my department to provide every necessary resource and support required by the multi-party approach. This multi-party approach, with the coordinating support of the department, has already served the Parliament well this year in implementing the significant reforms recommended by the Foster Review, And the success of this approach through the Foster Review has delivered positive outcomes, as I've indicated, for all parliamentarians and their staff. Third, the government will continue the existing supports that we already have in place. The dedicated unit support staff within the Parliamentary Workplace Support Service and the Independent Complaints Mechanism, 24-hour support line and the continued workplace safety training. These important supports will keep running and adapt as necessary as Parliament responds to these recommendations. We did not wait to receive this report to take action. We took action through the parallel commissioning of the Foster report and implementing those recommendations, so we now address these, not from a standing start, but already underway, taking action together to respond to the very serious issues that have been highlighted in this place. These are problems we all own, and they're problems we all have a responsibility together to fix. Race.
Thanks very much, Prime Minister.
And that's where we'll leave the Prime Minister. We will have all the details in the afternoon news and then in Nine News at 6. I'm Mark Burrows. Thanks for your company.